hire Prophet Jeremiah Mudifoye. I want to talk about individual prophecies and political prophecies. Political prophecies are prophecies that you have to be very, very careful. Individual prophecy, you can prophesy anytime, any hour. You can prophesy to a man who become a millionaire. He will become a billionaire. And the person will wait for the actual time. It's 2 years to come, he will become a billionaire. After 2 years, the person will not become a billionaire. You know, people will not look onto that. Only you and the person. But political prophecies are prophecies that you have to prophesy, and every eye on that post, every ear on that post, you have to be very, very careful as a prophet or as a prophetess or as a pastor or an apostle. Prophecies are from God. The same God that who gives prophecies to his servant. A tenor of 4 years, God can show mercy because many people are, you know, in beating that post in order to now have the throne. Let me tell you one thing. You prophesy to God, showing you something that you prophesy to a person. You have to be very, very careful. It's a war. You have to protect that prophecy so that, number one, your name will not spoil. Number two, your grace will not come down. Prophecy can make a man to lift up by second to the highest level. Prophecy can make a man to come down by second. So, any prophets out there, they are prophesying. I'm a prophet, I have to pass this message to you. The post that a person is now struggling for, that post is for mercy. It's for mercy. It is by God's mercy that God gives to the children. It can be A, it can be B, it can be C. Because the people that are now contesting for that post, they have also have prophets. They have pastors. So those pastors, they can show mercy upon one. Like what happened, the Bible says, in the book of Isaiah. This is a young man, Hezekiah. And the God Almighty now spoke to a prophet. Just go and now tell him that his days are numbered. Now the days was, he now just followed the instruction of God. And he gone straight to his house and he told him that this is how your days is what the Lord says. And the young man now said, I am finished. He looked onto the wall, now began to cry unto the Lord. He said, God, why do you allow this death come to my house? On his way going, the same God spoke to his prophet again. He said, go back, tell him that his days are added more 15 years. You know why? Because of mercy that he showed upon him. If like would have been a political prophecy, God showed you and you prophesied this, what will happen? When a prophet prophesied to a man or to a woman as a contestant, a political office, you have to be prayerful. You have given yourself a labor, hard labor, until this thing will come to pass. That's why today many prophets and many pastors, they fail. Political prophecy is like Nigerian mobile network. It's fluctuating. At times it went off, at times it comes in. If you see a political prophecy and God has shown you and you announce it out, you are giving a big labor to yourself as a pastor or as a prophet. 1 Kings 18, 42. You read down. This happened right in Mount Carmel. Elijah sent his servant. There was no rain in the land. And he sent his servant, just go straight to the cloud and go and set out there. There is a rain. And when he got there, he couldn't find any rain. He came back and he told his master, Master, there was nothing like rain. You know what the master was doing? He cast down his head in between the two legs. He was giving, it was a labor, because he wanted the thing to surely come to pass. That's what I'm saying. When you prophesy and to a man that you will be the winner, it's a big labor you are giving to yourself. Because you make sure that the person must win. If not, you will prophesy. Even ordinary prophecy, you prophesy, you go and rest. But political prophecy, you're giving yourself a labor. And you also guide it. So he now said him again, go. And he gone to the second time. He said, no, nothing like that. He still cast himself down. Elijah just sent him again. He gone again. Until the seventh time, he said, there was a cloud like in its hand. You see how the labor, because you have to fulfill it. And this is a warning to all prophets, pastors, apostles, bishops, that will prophesy anytime to prophesy. Many are prophesied and many are failed. But political prophecies, I warned all men of God, political prophecy is not the prophecy that you prophesy one-on-one. You have to be very, very careful so that you will not put your grace into shame. You will not put your grace into disgrace. Because that your grace God has given to you, the enemies are watching you. Many have tried, today they have failed. You have to be very, very careful. God sent Jonah to Nineveh. When he was going to Nineveh, God said, all of them will die. All will die. But on the way going, them, and these people repented. And God showed mercy upon them and they saved. You can see what I'm talking about. The people that were prophesying to politicians and also as a prophet, not that God is not showing them what they have seen. It is God that has shown them what they've seen. That along the line, it is the same God that who also showed to other prophets and pastors. And you now look at it, out among all that who are contested, from there he now shows his mercy to one of them. God is not a God of confusion, and God is a God of mercy. So, political prophecies, you have to be very, very careful. It's a serious warning to all men of God, in Nigeria especially. Nigeria, I'm warning them. I promise them, I'm warning you, people that who are political, this one will win, this one will win, this, that one will win. Who told you? God can change his mind to favor anyone. God can change his mind to favor any man, any woman. The post is for mercy. So, God bless you. I, Prophet Jeremiah Modufuin, I will pass this message to all clergymen in Nigeria, in Africa, and world at large. And God bless you.